I'm Zach Clark.
And I'm Michael Roger.
And we're reporting for STV News.
We'd like to start out with technology at Latham High School.
This is a story me and Mike worked on, and it covers the three steps the student in the Fairbanks North Star Borough can do.
Media and technology classes at Latham High School are preparing students for the future.
The Intro to Technology course not only is a feeder to Mr. Bodel's Communications Technology class, but also to other programs throughout the district through, programs through Hutchison Career Center. I find a lot of my freshman students that are really interested in things like automotive, small engine technology. I encourage them to go on to Hutchison and some of the outstanding programs we have there.
In Mr. Hussey's technology class, you can build cars and test them.
Also, in Mr. Hussey's class, you can build a bridge and then test it here. Technology students in Mr. Hussey's class may also build cities on a program called SimCity 2000. You can see here, my city is being destroyed by a large space monster. Not feeling very aerodynamically correct? You could test yourself in Mr. Hussey's wind tunnel. Another fun thing to do in Mr. Hussey's technology class is the flight simulator. As you can see here, it has a full aircraft-like dashboard. Yeehaw. As you can see, we plummeted to the ground and crashed. But no one was hurt in this crash. Hussey's class is just the beginning. As you move along in Lathrop High School, you'll get to Mr. Bodel's Communications Technology class, where you can do professional video editing like this.
Communications technology is probably the largest area of technology in the world. I mean, it's information technology. From the journalists, the photojournalists you see on television, to the anchorman, to the person behind the camera, to the person gathering information, putting it on Reuters News Service over the computer. You name it, it's there. I mean, the information is the biggest industry in the world anymore.
After taking one of Mr. Bodel's offered technology classes, there's one last class students can take. It is called Broadcast Journalism and teaches about the television news industry.
The first semester class, Broadcast Journalism 1, teaches the very basic skills of camera operation, microphones, lighting, script writing, interviewing, this kind of thing. The second semester moves into the actual production of a news magazine format program, where the students actually go out, they get the interviews, they edit them together into a news package, they put them on the show, they produce the show as producers, directors, lighting people, sound people, so that the class in the second semester is actually producing a news magazine show once a month. Third semester, they come back, and they come back purely as STV staff. Their sole responsibility is getting the news show on the air. After this class, after two semesters of this class, they can get a part-time or full-time job as a camera operator in any station. And conceivably, in small stations, in small towns, small markets, they can conceivably go in and move from camera operator fairly quickly into editing or conceivably even reporting.
Actually, I think this class is extremely well conceived as far as planning, as far as your instructor, who seems to be extremely knowledgeable. He has 20 plus years in the business in front and behind the camera. And that's really all it takes. You need to have a good, solid instructor. You have to also have students who are willing to invest the time to do a good job. Anyone can stick a camera in the middle of a room and shoot footage and ask questions, but it really does take dedicated students who care about the product, the end product, to pull off something on this scale, and I think you're doing a great job of it so far.
Fairbanks North Star Borough School District is preparing our youth for tomorrow's careers. This is Michael Roderick and Zach Clark reporting for STV.
Interested in law? Want to become an attorney? You should check out Youth Court. Nathan Eichelberger and Greta Johnson have a behind-the-scenes look on how teen justice is dealt with.
Youth Court is a national organization with more than 6,500 programs in 45 of our 50 states. North Star Youth Court, the youth court program here in the borough, has been established since 1996. Executive Director Wendy Leach has been with the program since its...
Youth Court serves as a diversion program to the formal juvenile justice system. And youth 12 to 18 years old are trained for approximately 20 hours to serve as attorneys, both prosecuting and defense attorneys, judges and clerks of court. Once they complete their training and pass the youth court bar exam, then they're formally sworn in by one of our superior court judges, and they serve as volunteers for the youth court.
We've got 135 youth attorneys that act as defense attorney or prosecuting attorney and take real cases through arraignment. The cases they're taking through are first-time misdemeanor offenders. The offenders are all under 18. The youngest we tend to take is 10 years old.
The main benefit towards the youth defendants is that youth court majorly consists of teens, creating a peer environment.
I think it really helps that the person is another teen because really teens understand each other a lot better than adults do, because we all know that everybody's going through the same kind of stuff.
It's important to be judged by your peers. You, as a youth, you tend to listen to what your friends have to tell you more than you'd listen to an adult who may not understand what you're going through. It's too long ago for them, and they just don't understand.
One option given to the defendants is the choice to go through training and re-enter the youth court program as a youth attorney. Caleb Koontz took that option and is now an active youth court member.
I think youth court has helped me a lot. It's given me a second chance because, if it wasn't there, I would be having a parole officer on my butt all the time, and I wouldn't be able to, he'd be always checking, he or she or, you know, whoever, would be always checking up on me, and my life wouldn't be the same.
Aside from the positive effects youth court has had on the community, I asked how it has affected the local legal system.
It's taking the burden off of them. Whether they were even going to deal with the case in the first place or close it out, we took 135 cases from the Division of Juvenile Justice in the year 2000. And those are cases that they would have had to deal with that are just misdemeanor offenses that are piddly towards them versus the major felony cases that they really need to dedicate their time to. And it's cases that may not have received the attention that they needed. These are kids who may not commit a crime after they've come through youth court because they've come through youth court.
TV News, I'm Nathan Eichelberger.
What happens when school-sponsored swimming ends for public high school students in Fairbanks, Alaska?
Why, they go to the Midnight Sun swim team.
Yes, they do. And two of our STV News reporters are part of the MSST.
Steph Merkley and Rachel Sherman have the story.
The Midnight Sun swim team is a competitive swim team here in Fairbanks where the swimmers range in age from 6 to 18. They compete against each other as well as the North Pole Aquatic Club, the Stingray swim team, and various other teams from out of town. Many of the high school swimmers come from the teams of Lathrop, West Valley, and Monroe. They've worked together to become one team. This year, for the first time, the coaches from Lathrop and West Valley are working together. Head coach Scott Lindley and assistant coach Leah Wainwright have been bringing their different philosophies and coaching experiences together for the team.
And for me, getting to know the person is the place I like to start.
You have to have patience in dealing with all of them.
Both Scott and Leah are bringing their different coaching experiences with them to MSST.
Maybe 10 years of experience under my belt, whereas Scott has, I don't even know how much experience he has under his belt.
I'm the head Lathrop coach. I was the head West Valley coach for 13 years back in the 70s, 80s, and 90s. And so now I'm coaching our crosstown rival.
I really think it's a good idea that we have a coach and an assistant coach so we can run it from two pools. And both of the coaches are really knowledgeable about swimming, and they're really willing to help you with your strokes.
I think it's really great. It really brings the teams together. It's good for everybody because both of them have different knowledge that they bring to the team. They're able to communicate well.
I think my favorite thing about coaching is the people that I meet. Both the swimmers that are on my team and the people that we meet when we go places and go to meets.
I enjoy that aspect of water being as much a partner and a friend and a coach as an opponent. I don't look at water as an opponent anymore. Water teaches you how to move through it cleanly and efficiently. If you don't do it correctly, you know right away because you don't get anywhere.
I feel like I'm getting a lot of help with the strokes I'm having problems with, and also improving the strokes that I feel need a little bit of tweaking. so that I can improve my times during the high school season.
Coach Scott is very good at letting me know how to use my energy, and Coach Leah helps with my technique.
Before we left, we asked the swimmers how it felt to swim with people from the opposite schools. None of them seemed intimidated.
It's nice to be able to know people from another school just outside of your own swimming program.
I think it really helps the teams come together, actually. I'm glad that we do, too, because I don't like having too much rivalry, you know. It's nice to be friends with your rival team, because then you can joke with each other and whatever else you want to do.
With their daily practices and meets on the weekends, MSST is working out well. For STV News, I'm Steph Merkley.
Besides swimming, there are other activities teenagers can do, such as snowboarding. Logan Graves and Colin Homer bring a camera to Moose Mountain to document the average life of a teenage snowboarder.
Hundreds of teenagers flock to the slope to perform awesome acrobatics. Snowboarders risk life and limb for the thrill of aerial ballet. We hit the slopes this weekend to record them doing what they do best.
Clear for one reason or the other. Catch an edge like right here, pushing me into like some fucking spinning backflip. Land like on my back and my neck. Knock all the wind out of me. See stars for a run or two.
Trick you can pull.
Probably like a 540 grab.
Excellent edition of STV News today.
I agree, that was some spectacular stories.
We are getting better each show, but we are gonna be
back next month.
Yes, so check in
for a brand new edition of STV News. I'm Zach.
And I'm Mike.
And we are signing off.
Later.